Hi, my name is Mia, and I just wanted to bring this over to you. I live right across the street, and, well, here. I didn't really know what to make, so I made a little bit of everything. Cookies, brownies, cupcakes. yeah, you can say that I like to bake. Anyways, I just really wanted to welcome you to the neighborhood. And I didn't really want to bombard you the first day you moved in, so yeah, I know how hard it can be getting settled in. And I'm sure you still have mountains of boxes to get through. Come in. No, I really don't want to bother you. Well, if you insist, honestly. If I'm being completely transparent, I've always wanted to see the inside of this house. Well, the previous owners weren't very welcoming, so you're going to think this is crazy, but at one point, I thought that they had this dungeon in their basement with how secretive they were. See? Just a little crazy. Oh, no dungeon? I don't know if it's worth a house tour then. No, I'm sorry. I didn't actually think you were going to give me one. I'm sorry. I can be a little awkward sometimes. Are you sure I won't bother you? Okay. Only for a minute, though. I really don't want to be too much of a hassle. So, what brings you to this neighborhood? Work? Are you far from where you originally grew up? Oh, wow. That is a little far. Me? Well, I'm actually a student right now. No. I'm not that young. I'm in medical school. Oh, God, no, please don't call me for emergencies. I am definitely not qualified just yet. Do I like it here? Yeah, it's really nice and super quiet and quaint. So, like I said, I live directly across the street from you. And your neighbors on the right? They are the sweetest little retired couple. I'm sure they'll start finding their way over and bringing you food. He actually used to be a chef, and he makes the world-famous Eggs Benedict, so... Oh, he's already started feeding you. That's good. I know how straining and exhausting moving can be, and it's not like you want to live on just pizza alone for the next couple weeks. No, I don't have anything against pizza, but, you know, it's not exactly a well-rounded meal for every day. Wow, this is actually a really large house. How many rooms does it have? Five? Do you have a family that'll be living with you? Oh, then if I can ask, why such a big home? Oh, that's nice. It's good to start thinking ahead like that. Are you dating anyone? Is that why you're thinking of the future? Oh, well, I'm sure you'll meet someone here in our city. You seem super sweet, and it doesn't hurt that you're super attractive. I'm sorry, I should just warn you, I am a little blunt, so... Yeah, I don't really have a filter, nor am I very conventional. Anyway, is this your movie collection? Well, you do have it on display for my judging eyes, and... In fact, looking around, it looks like it's the first and only thing you have completely set up, so how about we take a look? I like that everything is alphabetical. That means you're super organized, and I can appreciate that. But really, what has me curious is if I will see any of my favorites here. And there it is. The Prodigal Son. The original Star Wars trilogy. Perfect. Oh, well, Han shot first, of course. Okay, moving on. Ah, and all of the Harry Potters. I'm glad you're not the type to only have your favorites. In fact, quick, pop quiz. Favorite book and then movie from the Harry Potter series. Good choices. Well, I feel like I have a controversial choice for both. A Goblet of Fire? I know. I can't help it, though. It makes me feel like a kid. Now, let's see if you have some of my favorite horror movies. Yeah, well, I'm kind of a horror and gore girl. I mean, maybe you should be a little nervous, although I do see you have Texas Chainsaw Massacre, one of my favorites, and kind of tells me that maybe I should be nervous around you. And, ooh, The Devil's Rejects. It's super depraved, but yes, something about it, right? And classic horror movies, Halloween, Friday the 13th. Good collection. Is that Trick or Treat? Oh my god, this is one of my absolute favorite movies. Yes, it is totally and completely underrated. And is this Shaun of the Living Dead? Oh my god. All right, it's official. You pass. Well, it just means I won't be hesitant to invite you for a movie night. It looks like we have similar tastes. Though, I hope you won't be too turned off by some rom-coms once in a while. And you do have a really spacious living room, perfect for movie nights, so yeah, I guess I did invite myself over. Would that be okay? I could bring snacks over. Okay, well, you'll have to give me a list of your favorites. Mine? Well, popcorn is a staple, and peanut butter M&Ms. Oh, of course, the butteriest popcorn is the best popcorn. Although, okay, it's a little weird, and I get judged for it, but I also love jalapenos in my popcorn. I told you it's weird. Oh, gosh, look at the time. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bother you for so long. Oh, you're way too sweet. Well, yeah, it was really nice meeting you too, and, you know, sitting here and judging you on your movie taste. Well, I did see the Starship Troopers shoved right there in the corner, so don't think you're completely off the hook. You might have passed, but not with flying colors. Yeah, we'll talk more about it, but some other time. Can I have your number? I'll shoot you a text, and then you can have mine. Okay. All right, I'm ready. Okay. And sent. So how about you text me later and let me know which one of these desserts that I brought over you liked the best? Is it okay if I hug you? You give really good hugs and you smell super good. Are you okay if I kiss your cheek? all right, I'll get out of your hair now. I'm really looking forward to having movie nights with you in the future. Yeah, I guess we did skip the official house tour this time. But maybe next time you can try convincing me that there really isn't a dungeon in your basement. Yeah, the only way you'll convince me is by showing me. Anyway, I'll let you get back to it, and good luck unpacking. If you need anything, I'm just a text away. All right, bye for now.